Whether you're studying for an exam or you just want to learn about vitamin B7, in the next 5 minutes, I'll go over everything you have to know about vitamin B7 or biotin. Let's go. Vitamin B7 or biotin can be obtained from various sources of food, mostly from organs, bananas, and nuts. Like most other vitamin Bs, it acts as a coenzyme for various metabolic reactions within our body. For test purposes, enzymes that require vitamin B are also known as ABC enzymes, where the A stands for ATP, B for biotin, and C for carbon dioxide. These enzymes on our screen here are all ABC enzymes, and they all end with carboxylases. Propanol carboxylase, or PCC, is responsible for the catabolism or breakdown of branched-chain amino acids such as valine, leucine, and isoleucine, as well as the catabolism of odd-chain fatty acids. It converts propanol-CoA into methanol-CoA, which is later then becomes succinyl-CoA, and then it enters the Krebs cycle or the TCA cycle. There is no recommended daily intake or RDA since we only need very small amounts of biotin and it's so easily obtainable through diet. Instead, for biotin, there are only adequate intake or AI levels shown here. As with all B vitamins, deficiency in B7 is extremely rare, but there is one interesting case where the consumption of raw eggs. Raw eggs contain a protein called avidin, which will interfere with biotin absorption by binding onto biotin. However, to be clinically significant, you'd have to eat a lot of raw eggs. We're talking entire tubs of mayonnaise, hollandaise sauce, or aioli, or chugging jugs and jugs of eggnog at a time. Other causes of B7 deficiency include long-term antibiotic usage, alcoholism, and pregnancy. For this reason, along with folate, or B9, biotin is also a key component of prenatal pills. However, taking the excessive B7 throughout the course of pregnancy can actually be harmful to the fetus, so B7 supplementation is not recommended throughout pregnancy. When it comes to B7 deficiency, the most important for test-taking purposes is the propionic acidemia, where lower levels of B7 causes lower PCC activity, which increases propionic acid buildup, which can then cause acidosis and nausea. Other symptoms of B7 deficiency include alopecia, enteritis, dermatitis, or glossitis. There isn't any real medical data or evidence that backs up B7 supplementation, aside from prenatal pills prior to pregnancy. It's becoming common for people to take B7 for hair growth and maintaining good hair, skin, and nails. We're also seeing the ability of B7 to help control blood glucose levels in diabetics, multiple sclerosis treatment, and managing other types of neuropathies. However, all of these are still being studied. Like all water-soluble vitamins, B7 toxicity is extremely rare. Aside from the possibility of interfering with lab results due to high B7 concentrations in the blood, there isn't any serious toxicities to consider here.
If you like this video, consider subscribing to my YouTube channel and also follow me on my other social media platforms.